Welcome to End of the World Satsang. Instead of discussing non-dual clarity, which is what we usually discuss, I am focusing on the next year and a half of events in this world, specifically the latter part of July 2011. In previous videos, I have said that we will see the writing on the wall of the coming economic and financial collapse. We will begin to see very clearly that, yes, it's coming in late July. So, let me preface my remarks by talking about how is it possible to foresee the future. And I tell you for sure it is possible, but it's also very difficult. There is a certain, let's call it a level of clarity, which is pure objectivity, which is able to see the future perfectly. I can't explain how it does this, but it is true. And that is always perfectly clear about the future. Problem with what we can access that perfect clarity and see the future. The problem is, because we are not entirely non-objective, we have a stake in this world, and we want things to turn out a certain ways that totally skews our interpretation of what we see. So we may get perfect clarity like in a dream and know exactly what's going to happen, but as we wake up and our waking consciousness takes hold of us, it all becomes very foggy and distorted, and we can't quite remember. We remember certain aspects of it, but being able to accurately say this is going to happen on this and this day, and all that clarity, it vanishes. It's not there anymore. So that is why sometimes people will be accurate and sometimes they won't, depending on how much stake they have in a certain outcome. You see, if they have no stake in a certain outcome, then they are able to give a pretty accurate prediction of what's going to happen in the future. But if they have a stake in an outcome, it becomes much more difficult, and they're off. Sometimes their timing is off. Sometimes the events, they're not able to say exactly what's going to happen. It becomes more and more problematical, the prediction. Becomes unstable, not entirely accurate. So I've been a lifetime of seeing the future, and 55 years of it, and have been right, you know, countless thousands of times. But I've also stumbled sometimes. It does happen. It's extremely difficult because, as objective as I would like to be, it's just very, very problematical to be entirely objective as you're living here in this world. Okay, major events, you may not want them to happen. we're not at the level of perfect objectivity here. So not wanting something to happen is going to cause the prediction to be off in some regard. So we're looking at July, late July. I've known that the financial system and economy is going to collapse, totally collapse. I knew that the problems were coming in 2008, and when they came, I said right off the bat, I said, we are not going to recover from this. Okay, this is a downward spiral, and a lot of the experts said to me, this is going to bounce back quickly. I said, no, it's not, no way. And as we've gone on, you keep hearing recovery, 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 and I've always said, no, it's not going to recover. So on the today, or yesterday or today, the 17th, Goldman Sachs put out their forecast, really a prediction of the future. And talking about the economic growth, and their prediction is that it's going to be way, way less than anticipated. And in fact, it merits being said it's continued recession, or even more recession, because it's so sluggish. Okay, so this is a profound sign, a profound writing on the wall. As I said, the writing will be on the wall. That's what I'm talking about. This is a firm that doesn't just toss these things out idly. They have a track record of being pretty accurate of forecasting these types of things. So for them to say that the economy is going to be very sluggish and gloomy through 2012, 2013, into 2014. You know, we are talking about a very severe statement there. And that should be a very much of a warning to you that there will be more to come. As that statement matriculates through, you're going to find out that other major players are going to be chiming in soon and going to be saying, yeah, things are not good at all. We also have the sovereign debt crisis in Europe, and they're saying, you know what, folks? It's not working. We need a lot more money. And how many times have we heard that before? So those who keep saying we're going to bounce back, you know, those are Pollyanna cheerleaders. They're not really facing what's going to come. So unfortunately for them, because it's going to put them in a deeper and deeper hole as things go along. But we here can look and try to be objective about it. I'm able to see the future because I have very little stake in this world. For me, the world is a neutral thing. I don't really care one way or the other about it. I don't care about my destiny in the world. I don't have any investments in anything here. Actually dirt poor. Don't have any future whatsoever. So I don't have a stake in this game, in this world. Very tiny stake in it. So that way, when I get information from the level of pure objectivity, I'm able to do a pretty good job of getting it through, but imperfect, to say the least. Okay, and I'm saying that July 20th, around that time, is going to be some major news in the world of some type. I don't know exactly what it's going to be at this point. I'm not sure if it's going to be something very dramatic or something that's kind of buried in the news that is a very strong indicator of what's to come. And I will, you know, I'm continually trying to pay attention to this and to get a better sense of it. But I believe that July 20th is going to be kickoff time, like for a marathon race, so to speak, the next 4 or 5 months, I guess, August, September, October, November. That would be 4 months. Is going to see, it's like a lot of smoke, tremendous smoke, and at some point you realize, oh my gosh, the building's on fire. You know, if you're looking at it from a distance and you see a tremendous amount of smoke just mushrooming up, you know, how long does it take you before you start to realize that there's a massive fire taking place? You know, some get it quicker than others. Some look at the distance and see puffs of smoke coming up. They see a little smoke and they say, there shouldn't be smoke there. There's got to be a fire. And then they know, well, that area is a lot of brush, tinder dry, hot, you know, Santa Ana winds. The conditions are just right, you know, to spread the fire, and you know it's going to be a huge problem. Whereas other people might glance at it and say, well, maybe there's a little brush fire. It's no big deal. So the more accurate and clear you are about conditions, the less stake you have in any outcome, the easier it is to notice the red flags and to draw the right conclusions from them. And I would say Goldman Sachs announcement is one very strong red flag. The sovereign debt crisis in Europe, talking about how they need a tremendous amount of money just to try to keep things going right now, again, is another big red flag. And I expect there's an even bigger one coming on July 20th. Something is going to shake up those who are alert enough to the situation, and they're going to start paying more attention. Like, you see the smoke in the distance and they see it and they say, that's not good. That is not good. Okay, it's like that. So if I get more information on it, I will post it. I don't want to speculate too much. I have some suspicions, but I've not entirely cleared them up yet. It's still a little muddy. But let us stay tuned to this situation. And again, I do suggest people start to dig into the idea of non-dual clarity, non-dual realization. Because what that does is it helps you back away from having stakes in the destiny of this world. The more you believe that you're your being is somehow inexorably tied to the destiny of this world, the more unstable you will feel, the more anxiety, the more fear, the more desperation, the more reactive you will be. But the more you realize that what you are is completely unaffected by the destiny of this world or any other world, our cosmos, our universe, completely unaffected by it, you're going to feel much more stable, much more calm, and see much more objectively what's taking place. So, as the countdown comes, let us see what comes to light over the next several days. Okay, very good. That's it.